Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Dubai Expat YouTube channel. In today's video, I take you with me to our third Watch Club get-together. We do these get-togethers usually once a month, and for today's gathering, we decided to meet in the Armani Lounge at the Burj Khalifa. Usually, we have some banger watches at our get-togethers. During the last one, the value of all watches together was around $150,000. So let's see if we can beat it in today's get-together. The lounge is located inside the Armani Hotel and looks very nice for gatherings and mingling around with other people. As usually, I won't talk a lot in this video, so you can listen a little bit to our conversations and enjoy the watches. Only problem is somehow the camera you see makes reflections.
That's
very weird, huh?
That's very weird.
So maybe we ask for the table that's reserved for us.
There is a table reserved for us?
I think so. Hey.
Exactly 10.
Yeah.
So I can offer for you this table. You can
put
it on the
book
as well.
Yeah.
The 8-way, does that have the old style bracelet?
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's got the flat link
bracelet.
It's got the original movement, and
they've
coated it.
Are you
on
Airbus or Boeing?
Airbus. Right. And the SLI has got the little engraving.
Yeah. So they're more than happy to give me the sapphire, sort of the crystal, and they'll put on a hazelite on it. I think it's for like 200 dirhams. So
what?
Yeah.
For 200 dirhams?
That's what you need to go for sapphire sandwich.
Then you shouldn't even buy the polish. It's probably more expensive than getting a new.
And the work you need to do with it.
No, but Naj, to be honest, I'm not a fan of modifying watches. So
that's not a modification. That's the.
But you'll always have the sapphire crystal with you anyway. So if you want to put it in again.
Yeah. I would leave it as it is and probably get another one then. So yeah, my hope is maybe that they remove this halo ring.
Because there was actually a model like this 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Which had a S-light on the front and a sapphire.
Yeah.
On the
front.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Okay.
So my hope is maybe that they remove the halo for the new version. And then, okay, whatever it takes, I get the new one. Sapphire sandwich, maybe have no halo anymore.
Yeah.
Keep the old one and
hey, how are you?
Hey man, have best of both worlds, you know?
Yeah.
So let's.
You guys have like a couple minutes.
True.
Yes, I am.
For sure, yeah, for sure. They've got like 2 minutes safe.
Yeah,
basically.
Is that?
Is that, yeah.
And this is like the perfect strap you have for it.
It's a beautiful strap.
Yeah.
So bad. I got married a week ago. And my wife is like, I guess you're not stopping the watches.
I dinged the lug already.
It's giving you more motivation for him, really.
Yeah, exactly.
But I also dinged my Explorer a few
get
times
it all
already.
Out
get it out of the way.
Best way.
We said the Armani, not Dubai Mall.
not Armani Exchange Dubai Mall.
I've never been here.
And then I hope Noor can somehow make
else.
It.
Oh, God.
Oh, you have the Patek today? Oh, yeah. And even though all pieces were paid, and they had only five pieces for whole UAE. And then he just told them, okay, give someone the money back.
See, that's the thing, I don't like the manga class.
Don't give it out. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, for the guy, it's really sad, you know, like, he paid it, he waited like half a year nearly or so for it.
Yes, found a good
and then...
I don't know, we'll see.
What do you mean, why is it illegal? As in...
Yeah, because you have to comply with the maximum duty times and stuff like this.
Okay.
Yeah. Because I'm so much in the limit, I can swap for
I think it's got sapphire.
I'll try to ask for days off and we'll see.
Okay.
How long is this one?
6,000.
But, yeah.
Man, look, for March, I have 4 Rolex orders, which I probably going to pick up. 4 Rolex watches.
Yeah, that is quite...
And we just calculated those 4 are already like $35,000 or so.
Yeah.
Then maybe Beer is going for 2 watches.
Okay, fair enough.
Ray probably wants to join for 1 more piece.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And let's see, I mean, if we have Ezard with us.
I enjoyed so much.
I don't know, he knows him.
I'm swimming.
And he bought the AP.
The third one. That guy's got, you know.
So happy he went for the line. So happy.
That's what he was just saying.
Yeah. So man, he scared me.
I was actually afraid that you were going to go for
yeah, me too.
I was.
And...
It's amazing, isn't it?
I think you know Nudge, then probably Noor will join later, but he's still in a meeting, and you know him. And then we had Mark, and I'm not sure why, but Mark is pretty busy with his wife at the moment.
I'm gonna reject it. If anyone wants it, you can have it.
And...
You got 2 Pepsis, you got another Pepsi here.
Yep, we will add it
actually,
later.
Keep your own, right? We might mix it up.
If it was like full gold,
you need to be getting the list for everything else.
Yeah,
yeah,
well, that's as good.
We can just take Roman.
It's okay, mate.
They're
testing. You see the limits.
The only occasion of this blah blah. Says literally the brigade would personally deliver it themselves. Vacheron at the beginning was saying we were selling in the millions a year.
Yeah. No, not.
Funny enough, the guy over here, the store manager here is Syrian Armenian. Mm-hmm. He was saying one of the biggest countries to buy from Vacheron is Armenia.
Yeah, the OPs, the Datejust, 41 Blue Dial, Sea Dweller, everything for sale there.
What is the markup is about 16-17%, I think you're right.
Ah, okay.
His OPs were like 13k more.
Oh, really?
I'm like, even after tax, whatever the tax is over there.
Yeah.
Still.
So in today's meeting, all watches together from their current market value are worth a little bit more than $200,000.
Next up should come with security.
It has the name of a company. And imagine if I would have my Pepsi now here as well, 3 Pepsis. Everyone thinks, oh yeah. My god, it's the most common watch on the world. Pepsis everywhere.
Is it this one?
Yes.
The light blue? Yeah, this
only
one.
Only Nord was
here. That's a specific name.
Yeah, this is annual, right? Annual calendar.
Yeah, skydiving.
Can't quite make it to grand complications.
I mean, that is a complication.
Yeah. I'm debating whether I should put it on a winder.
Yeah. Because you probably a ball length to set it each time, right?
Yeah, I just wind it like manually every month.
The dial is so different.
The new ones are better. Yeah. I tried the new.
I mean, I'm not an expert, but I would feel better to have it on a winder than all the time set it manually with my hands. I think that's. I would feel that's more stress.
To be honest, it's quite enjoyable to say.
Yeah, once, yeah, just you and your watch at that point.
The ballpark values are highest, like minus 10 plus 20, but it's usually around plus 20.
Okay, make sure you get the clasp.
You wanted to record something?
Yeah. Waiting for the Dom to move.
Cappuccino with a big layer of gold on top.
Yeah, it's
he has the cappuccino, can you imagine that? Nothing more. sure?
Yeah, of course. So, how is the golden cappuccino, Rami?
Just
you love it?
It's just a cappuccino. Honestly speaking, it's even, how to say, it's not really great cappuccino, but just the golden.
Does it have a flavor, no? Of gold?
And the highlight to close the session, the Patek annual calendar regulator on my wrist. The watch normally comes with a pin buckle, and our friend changed it to a folding clasp, which alone comes at around $4,000. That's it for now, guys. I hope you liked the video. Join our Facebook group for future events, and hopefully see you all in the next one. Until then, stay healthy and bye bye.